An aurora, plural, auroras, sometimes referred to as polar lights, northern lights, aurora borealis, or southern lights, aurora australis, is a natural light display in the Earth's sky, predominantly seen in the high latitude regions around the Arctic and Antarctic.
Auroras are produced when the magnetosphere is sufficiently disturbed by the solar wind that the trajectories of charged particles in both solar wind and magnetospheric plasma, mainly in the form of electrons and protons, precipitate them into the upper atmosphere due to Earth's magnetic field where their energy is lost.
The resulting ionization and excitation of atmospheric constituents emits light of varying color and complexity. The form of the aurora, occurring within bands around both polar regions, is also dependent on the amount of acceleration imparted to the precipitating particles. Precipitating protons generally produce optical emissions as incident hydrogen atoms after gaining electrons from the atmosphere. Proton auroras are usually observed at lower latitudes.
Auroras frequently appear either as a diffuse glow or as curtains that extend approximately in east-west direction. At sometimes they form quiet arcs, at others they evolve and change constantly. These are called active aurora.
The most distinctive and brightest are the curtain-like auroral arcs. Each curtain consists of many parallel rays, each lined up with the local direction of the magnetic field, consistent with auroras being shaped by Earth's magnetic field. In situ particles, measurements confirm that auroral electrons are guided by the geomagnetic field and spiral around them while moving toward Earth. The similarity of an auroral display to curtains is often enhanced by the folds within the arcs. Arcs can fragment or break up into separate, at times rapidly changing, often rayed features that may fill the whole sky.
These are the discrete auroras, which are at times bright enough to read a newspaper by at night, and can display rapid sub-second variations in intensity. The diffuse aurora, on the other hand, is a relatively featureless glow, sometimes close to the limit of visibility. It can be distinguished from moonlit clouds by the fact that stars can be seen undiminished through the glow. Diffuse auroras are often composed of patches whose brightness exhibits regular or near-regular pulsations. The pulsation period can be typically many seconds, so it is not always obvious. Often there are black aurora, narrow regions in diffuse aurora with reduced luminosity. A typical auroral display consists of these forms appearing in the above order throughout the night.
Red. At the highest altitudes, excited atomic oxygen emits at 630.0 nm. Low concentration of atoms and low sensitivity of eyes at this wavelength make this color visible only under more intense solar activity. The low amount of oxygen atoms and their gradually diminishing concentration is responsible for the faint appearance of the top parts of the curtains. Scarlet, crimson, and carmine are the most often seen hues of red for the auroras.
Green. At lower altitudes, the more frequent collisions suppress the 630.0 red mode. Rather, the 557.7 green dominates. Fairly high concentration of atomic oxygen and higher eye sensitivity in green make green auroras the most common. The excited molecular nitrogen, atomic nitrogen being rare due to high stability of the N2 molecule, plays a role here, as it can transfer energy by collision to an oxygen atom, which then radiates it away at the green wavelength. The rapid decrease of concentration of atomic oxygen below about 100 kilometers is responsible for the abrupt-looking end of the lower edges of the curtains. Both the 557.7 and 630.0 wavelengths correspond to forbidden transitions of atomic oxygen, slow mechanism that is responsible for the graduality of flaring and fading.
Let's look up forbidden transitions. In spectroscopy, a forbidden mechanism, or forbidden transition, or forbidden line, is a spectral line associated with absorption or emission of light by atomic nuclei, atoms, or molecules, which undergo a transition that is not allowed by a particular section rule, but is allowed if the approximation associated with that rule is not made. For example, in a situation where, according to usual approximations, such as the electric dipole approximation,